people often forget about kind of hallways, corridors, hall stairs and landings, and they can be a bit dull.
Yeah.
You have not got dull corridors and walls. These are fabulous.
Thank you.
Some of them man-made.
Yes.
Some of them natural.
Yes.
Talk me through.
Yeah. So this was already here when we got the house. Mm-hmm. It's obviously just all rendered. I really like the texture and I didn't want to get rid of it. And I think it just gives so much more interest than a very plain, smooth wall. So
it's not that kind of hideous Artex sort of rough, is it? This is almost like Portuguese villa or Mediterranean villa, you know, where they've got that really rough cast.
Yes.
It's like that, isn't it? It's chunky, it's bold and kind of in your face.
It is.
Textured, isn't it?
It is. Mm. I do. I really like
these.
These
are cool.
Thank you, yeah. I'm assuming
you haven't added those.
We haven't. I think that's part of the structure. But I'm glad they're there because, they do. They add a little bit more interest to the wall. So,
And what about this one?
So this one was just a plain wall, but this was Chris's idea. I can't take any credit for this.
Cost-effective or what?
Yeah, definitely. It was old magazines. Reason Snowboard magazine. It's a free magazine as well. Right. So we had lots of copies of it.
Not only then is it a magazine, so it's not wallpaper you had to buy.
Nope.
It's a free magazine.
Free magazine, yeah. So totally free. We just had to get the wallpaper first and took some time to cut them up. But it was really good quality paper in the magazine as well. So we just cut the pages up and then used it as a wallpaper. So it's just all made up of individual pages from the snowboarding magazine.
It is quite amazing that it's a snowboarding magazine and it picks up the whites and the blacks and the greys and all the colours and
the
textures.
Colour scheme of it. Yeah.
You couldn't actually have picked a magazine that
perfect.
Better reflected
it was.
Your interior design style.
Yeah, it was really perfect.
Clever. The hallways are different on different levels.
Yeah, that's right, yes.
Let's have a look at the other ones. Chris is a photographer, isn't he?
That's right, yes.
So these are his beauties.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
That's a great idea to use the walls not just for putting artwork on but actually to display something you really love.
The cameras are all vintage, all got from kind of secondhand shops and things. But I think it just creates more interest, really. So why not display the stuff that's personal to you in your home? I'm a big believer in that as well. So it's not just for frames and pictures. I think it's just nice to have things on display that reflect your personality. So
absolutely.
Yeah.
And there's an interesting story about Chris and the floor, I believe.
Yes. So these are the original floorboards in the cottage.
And you made a conscious decision not to have carpet, so different flooring.
Different flooring, that's right.
To add interest and just...
Yeah. Yes, adds a little bit of interest and it's quite practical in the attic because it just keeps it a little bit warmer as well. But we decided to keep these exposed and we sanded them down a little bit and then Chris used coffee to... add a little bit of colour to them.
Of course he did.
And then we just used a matte varnish over the top of it, but I quite like it actually. It's given it quite a nice little colour.
Why coffee?
No idea.
Did
I
think he read that somewhere?
I think he must have read it somewhere and then...
Cost-effective?
Yeah, cost-effective.
Cost-effective coffee?
Yeah, absolutely. So, sick of it in your cup, you just spill it on the floor and then wipe it in a bit and then jobs are good. So, sorted.
Sometimes it's not about what you do, it's about what you don't do.
Yeah.
And leaving some of the floorboards with the original paint on, and this beautiful wall, which some people will be horrified by.
Yeah, no, we loved it. It was a bit of a surprise. We obviously lifted up all the carpets and then took all the wallpaper off because the whole house was wallpapered. Mm-hmm. And then when we saw that, we just absolutely loved the colours and the textures. I think you can actually get wallpaper in that design now as well.
Oh my goodness,
yeah,
and you pay over £100 a roll for it.
We did, we loved it.
It is, it's beautiful,
just like
really
beautiful. The texture's just gorgeous, isn't it?
It is gorgeous, and I think sometimes it's about celebrating the rawness and the natural finishes rather than trying to cover them up and create something perfect. You sort of celebrate the imperfections.
Definitely, yeah. And I think it just adds character to your home, really. I think use what's there. I wouldn't want to cover anything like this up. Obviously it's been a painted floor before, so we've just kind of stripped it back a little bit, but just left it. All I've done is put a matte varnish over it.
And of course, coffee is really struggles to dye paint anyway.
I know, this is it, exactly. So yeah, that's the coffee area. This has just been left natural, so.
This
and the wall.
Is the most glorious wall.
How lucky are you
to have this as the...
Very. This was, again, accidental. We pulled the wallpaper off and the wall just started to fall down.
This was the wallpaper very, very, very bumpy?
It was horrible, yeah.
I wonder why.
So we just left it. We started at the bottom and then just eventually decided to chip the whole lot off and then we've got some lovely beams as well. But yeah, I think it's just going back to just using what is already here in the house and just celebrating the original features. So
and not we'll try everybody, because not everybody's house is going to have this beautiful stonework. Most people have brick, brick walls. So if you've got this, then expose it, show it off, and
absolutely make a feature of it.
Praise it, lovely. It's beautiful. It's very tactile, isn't it? As you walk down, it's nice. You sort of give it a little bit of a silky though. No,
it clicks claws. Definitely. But yeah, but we haven't sealed it or anything either. But we haven't really needed to. I know a lot of people will do it and they'll repoint and seal it, but I think I just like how rustic it is.